you were already looking more relaxed.
Life is good.
Yeah. I guess so. So 39 years. 39 years. Does it seem like it's been 39 years?
Yeah, it does. Thankfully, you didn't have a picture of me when I first started. We would have seen
No, we tried to track one down. They hadn't invented film yet. No. So. Well,
by the way, Dan, this is a very big moment for me. You know, you try to do as well as your parents in life. My father was a guest on Phil Donahue once, and I'm here.
Wait a minute. Yeah. What? Yeah. Wait a minute.
It's pretty much the same thing.
It pretty
I think.
Much is. I've known you for a long time. You've never revealed this to me. Your dad was a guest on Donahue?
Yeah, it was a little show they did many years ago, because the show hasn't been on for a long time, on inclusive language in the Bible, in the lectionary.
Uh-huh.
And so it was kind of a cutting edge at the time, and
that's
not so
impressive.
Much anymore.
Well, hey, I
Thanks
mean, Donahue was huge. I mean, not as big as this, but huge.
No, it's pretty similar.
Pretty good, yeah. So, wow, that's incredible. So 39 years, though. So what's been the high point? I mean, you look at all the big sports moments, right? You have the Sox winning the World Series. You had the Maine hockey team winning the national championship twice. Had some great women's basketball success. But the high point for you outside of what you've covered, what has been the high point for you as a professional at WBI?
I wouldn't probably be very good at my job if I waited for national championships or waited for amazing things like that to happen. Mm-hmm. It's the things that happen every day that are really riveting, showing people in their joys and showing the victories of young people's athletics and them talking about it. And you know, honestly, people I interview love to be interviewed. Mm. If you go into a Red Sox locker room, Patriots locker room, they don't want to talk
right.
to you.
Yeah.
They would rather avoid you.
Yeah.
And
yeah.
So I have the joy of being able to interview and interact with people that, you know, kind of work both ways.
Yeah.
They wanted to be on TV, local TV, and I get to interview people all the time that were just fantastic athletes and great performers.
That's very cool. Yeah. You've not only been interviewing, but you've also been behind the mic for calling some of these events as well. Have you enjoyed that part of the work as well?
Back in my day, we
that was just yesterday.
We
Tim.
Started. Everybody that was on TV started in radio. Now people go to these communication schools and they get really gifted at it in school and they go look for TV jobs. We all started on radio. So I started. George Hale hired me. Rich Kimball, George Hale, 1980, and we all sort of were groomed to be able to do radio shows and call games. And so we all did. Tim Cotton, Dan White, Dave Glidden, Jim Morris, we started at the same time. We did radio, and radio games are really cool.